Alleluia, Christ is risen. The Lord is risen indeed. Alleluia. Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord. Amen. Be with you. Let us pray. O God, who on this day taught the hearts of your faithful people by sending to them the light of your Holy Spirit, grant us by the same Spirit to have a right judgment on all things and evermore to rejoice in the holy comfort of the Spirit's presence. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. When the day of Pentecost had come, they were all together in one place, and suddenly from heaven there came a sound like the rush of a violent wind, and it filled the entire house where they were sitting. Divided tongues as of fire appeared among them, and a tongue rested on each of them. All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other languages as the Spirit gave them ability. Now there were devout Jews from every nation under heaven living in Jerusalem. And at this sound, the crowd gathered and was bewildered because each one heard them speaking in the native language of each. Amazed and astonished, they asked, "Are not all these who are speaking Galileans? And how is it that we hear each of us in our own native language? Parthians, Medes, Elamites, and residents of Mesopotamia, Judea and Cappadocia, Pontus and Asia, Phrygia and Pamphylia, Egypt and the parts of Libya belonging to Cyrene, and visitors from Rome, both Jews and proselytes, Cretans and Arabs. In our own languages, we hear them speaking about God's deeds of power. All were amazed and perplexed, saying to one another, 'What does this mean?' But others sneered and said, 'They are filled with new wine.' But Peter, standing with the 11, raised his voice and addressed them, 'Men of Judea and all who live in Jerusalem, let this be known to you and listen to what I say. Indeed, these are not drunk, as you suppose, for it is only 9 o'clock in the morning. No, this is what was spoken through the prophet Joel. In the last days it will be, God declares, that I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, and your young men shall see visions, and your old men shall dream dreams. Even upon my slaves, both men and women, in those days I will pour out my spirit, and they shall prophesy. And I will show portents in the heavens above, and signs on the earth below, blood and fire and smoky mist. The sun shall be turned to darkness, and the moon to blood, before the coming of the Lord's great and glorious day. Then everyone who calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved. The word of the Lord.
Psalm 104, verses 25 through 35. You're invited to read along, either in unison or responsively by the half verse. O Lord, how manifold are your works!
In wisdom you have made them all. The earth is full of your creatures.
Yonder is the great and wide sea with its living things, too many to number.
Creatures, both small and great.
There move the ships, and there is that Leviathan,
which you have made for the sport of it.
All of them look to you
to give them their food in due season.
You give it to them, they gather it.
You open your hand, and they are filled with good things.
You hide your face, and they are terrified.
You take away their breath, and they die and return to their dust.
You send forth your spirit, and they are created.
And so you renew the face of the earth.
May your glory, O Lord, endure forever.
May you rejoice in all your works.
You look at the earth, and it trembles.
You touch the mountains, and they smoke.
I will sing to the Lord as long as I live.
I will praise my God while I have my being.
May these words of mine please you.
I will rejoice in the Lord. Alleluia.
A reading from the letter of Paul to the Romans. All who are led by the Spirit of God are children of God. For you did not receive a spirit of slavery to fall back into fear, but you have received a spirit of adoption. When we cry, Abba, Father, it is that very Spirit bearing witness with our spirit that we are the children of God. And if children, then heirs, heirs of God and joint heirs with Christ, if, in fact, we suffer with him, so that we may also be glorified with him. The word of the Lord.
A reading from the Gospel of John. Philip said to Jesus, Lord, show us the Father, and we will be satisfied. Jesus said to him, Have I been with you all this time, Philip, and you still do not know me? Whoever has seen me has seen the Father. How can you say, Show us the Father? Do you not believe that I am in the Father and the Father is in me? The words that I say to you, I do not speak on my own, but the Father who dwells in me does his works. Believe me that I am in the Father and the Father is in me. But if you do not, then believe me because of the works themselves. Very truly, I tell you, the one who believes in me will also do the works that I do, and in fact will do greater works than these, because I am going to the Father. I will do whatever you ask in my name, so that the Father may be glorified in the Son. If in my name you ask me for anything, I will do it. If you love me, you will keep my commandments, and I will ask the Father, and he will give you another advocate to be with you forever. This is the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it neither sees him nor knows him. You know him, because he abides with you, and he will be in you. I have said these things to you while I am still with you. But the Advocate, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, will teach you everything and remind you of all that I have said to you. Peace I leave with you. My peace I give to you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled. And do not let them be afraid. The word of the Lord. May the words of my mouth and the meditation of our hearts be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. Now there's temptations to a preacher on this week to always go to the lesson from Acts, because that's the big lesson that we hear every Pentecost. It's the one that gives this feast day its name. It's the one that we focus on with the wind and the tongues as of fire, and we wear fire colors, and we celebrate that gift of the Spirit. And I could preach on that here at the beginning of Pride Month, as the Spirit does not make everyone alike, but welcomes each one. It's almost like puts a stamp of approval on that wide diversity, that all these different languages all bear witness to the glory of God. But this year I really need to stick with the Gospel of John and to drill deep into this part of the final words that Jesus offers to his disciples on that night before he is crucified. As he is giving them the last words, the things that are most important. As he reminds them that he is giving them peace and that they don't need to be afraid. Do not let your hearts be troubled, neither let them be afraid. It takes some time to get there. We know as the story unfolds and the disciples scatter in fear and deny and run away, it's a hard thing to do, to learn to travel and to trust this new advocate that Jesus sends. I will ask the Father, and he will give you another advocate to be with you forever. This is the Spirit of truth. And I think this is the gift that we all need to focus on this week. At least I know I do. This gift of, the Greek word is parakletos, the paraclete. Some translations don't even try to put it into an English word that we know. They just transliterates it as the paraclete, because it's a word that carries so many different depths of meaning. At its basic meaning, it's the one who comes alongside, as Jesus has been the one alongside these disciples for these years. I'm going to give you another paraclete, another one coming alongside you to be with you forever. And we know that coming alongside us means that the Holy Spirit has a wide variety of circumstances to deal with. Sometimes the word advocate might be the one that we need most, the one who stands and speaks on our behalf. The advocate, the translation that our reading today uses for that paraclete, though sounds a little bit more legal term, the one who pleads your case next to you, the one who speaks up for you, the one who advocates on your behalf. Other translations choose the word comforter, and that is a term that we so often need the Holy Spirit to fully engage with, for we need comfort. Maybe that's the one we've felt the most need for in these last weeks. Comfort. I give you one who will come alongside you in comfort, that you do not let your hearts be troubled. Other translations move to the word helper, intercessor, the one who comes along to help us in our life, in our work, the counselor, the one who offers us alongside us what we need to hear, not to advocate for us out there, but to maybe to advocate to us, the message of God that comes to us. Sometimes we need to hear that message tell us peace. And sometimes we need that message and that counselor to tell us courage, for you are never alone. I am with you. This is that incredible gift of the Holy Spirit, that Jesus says it's not just God in human flesh who can be in one place at one time, but that amazing, awe-filled power of the Spirit of God that can breathe over creation, that can be alongside each one of us always, to be with us forever. And that coming and that power give us, Jesus offers, says, and with that, you'll do greater things, greater works than I have done. For I'm going away, and you will all bear the Spirit of God that I have been. Now, I don't know about you, but I haven't gone around raising people from the dead or healing lepers or making blind people see or lame people leap for joy or... But, you know, in the Gospel of John, those are not what's focused on us, the works that Jesus does. The works that Jesus does are these works that point to God's love, that bring present God's peace, that make tangible God's love. And we can do these works. And we are to do these works. And so this Pentecost, at this time in our lives where we each find ourselves in such different places. I know at least one of you is watching this from a nursing home. And what you need from the Holy Spirit on this day is different than what the 23-year-old needs who is just graduating from college. But the Holy Spirit is there for each one of us, bringing us alongside us, being with us forever with what we need today. The comfort, the courage, the guidance, the peace, the power to do today what we believe we cannot do. And that is proclaiming and making present God's love. No matter what situation we are in, no matter where we are not let loose from that call. And we can do that in great ways. And because the Comforter comes to be with us, come alongside us, and be with us forever, we can have the courage to speak God's message to this world in ways and in languages that all can understand. Not to make the world all alike, but to let the diversity of the world welcome our voices in ways that it hears that they are loved, that the Comforter is there to come with them, that the power of God's love and the Spirit of truth walks this land with each of us. And that maybe in that we can find the hope and the courage to tackle whatever task and whatever place in our world in front of us this day needs that voice of the Spirit of truth. I was praying in our brand new labyrinth this last week at a point where I was feeling almost hopeless that the voices of God's people that come from many different political parties, from many different walks of life, that say that there can be common sense ways of protecting life, protecting our children, protecting each other. There can be common sense ways of fighting against racial injustice, against losing the voice of the undernourished, the underpowered, the underrepresented. And as I poured out my heart to God, as I walked my way through that labyrinth in prayer, I recognized in that labyrinth, yeah, sometimes I feel like my path is taking and our path is taking us farther away from the hope that we want to cling to, from the center of our soul and the center of God's peace for this world. And then I would turn another corner. And going forward on that same path, I would once again draw closer and get a glimpse of the goal, of the center. It is like our lives. We are called to keep moving forward, even when that path seems to swing away, to keep moving, knowing that the Paraclete, the Holy Spirit, has come alongside us and given us the power to do greater works than even Jesus did. Because we are the voice and the hands and the heart and the soul of the Spirit of Christ in this world now. You and me and many spread out throughout this world. Not just one Jesus and one Palestine at one time, but with all of us bearing the Spirit of truth, walking forward with it, we can have this world be a place that hears that message, that knows the comfort, that understands the power of peace, of not being afraid, the power of the God of love, of the God of mercy, of the God of justice, of the God of life, the God of truth. The Paraclete brings that to us this day and always. From the beginning of time, the Holy Spirit's coming was not something brand new at Pentecost, but there were people willing and ready to open their lives to the power of it. May we do the same. Amen.
Thank you. Let us pray. Holy God, we give thanks for the coming of the Spirit to your church. We pray for the parishes of our diocese, for our interdenominational partners in this community, and for our own parish. May the gifts of the Spirit be revealed in all your people. May the church share the gifts that you have given to it. May we go out in the power of the Spirit to proclaim your love by word and deed. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for all who through their talents enrich and beautify our world, for artists and writers, craftspeople and broadcasters, for all who communicate and who work in education, for all those who through their talents provide us with food and clothing. We remember all whose talent is unused through fear or opposition, all who feel thwarted in their ambitions and gifts. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We give you thanks for the working of the Spirit in our lives, for the gifts we have and the guidance we have received. We pray for those who have been our teachers and educators, for all who have brought us into a fuller and richer life. We remember our homes and our loved ones, and those who celebrate birthdays or anniversaries this week. You are invited to name your own thanksgivings. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for all who feel fearful and close themselves in, for those who are locked in by anxiety or guilt, for all who are afraid to venture and risk. We remember all whose lives are restricted by illness or disability, all who are frustrated by limiting circumstances. We pray for the people of Ukraine and for all who are displaced by war. We pray for the victims and families affected by gun violence. We pray for loved ones who are ill. You are invited to name those for whom you pray. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We give thanks that you are the God who breathes new life into us. You are the God who restores and refreshes us. We give thanks that you give us new life in your kingdom. We remember before you our friends and loved ones departed, that they may share with your saints in glory. You are invited to name those who have died. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Holy Father, fill us with the Holy Spirit, the power of the living God. Guide us by the Holy Spirit, the giver of light and life. Strengthen us through the Holy Spirit, the fire of love. Let your Spirit come upon us and change us and all your faithful people, that we may live and work to your praise and glory. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
And now I invite you to join with me in the general thanksgiving. Let us pray together. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all for your immeasurable love in the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts, we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days, through Jesus Christ, our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen. And now may God bless you. May God bless you through the presence of the Advocate, the Comforter, the Holy Spirit who is with you always. May God bless you through that with a restless discomfort about easy answers, half-truths and superficial relationships, so that you may seek truth boldly and love deep within your heart. May God bless you with holy anger at injustice, oppression, and exploitation of people and the creation, so that you may tirelessly work for justice, freedom, and peace among all. May God bless you with a gift of tears to shed for those who suffer from pain, rejection, starvation, or the loss of all that they cherish, so that you may come alongside them, may reach out your hand to comfort them, and in your presence, transform their pain into joy. And may God bless you with enough foolishness to believe that you really can make a difference in this world, so that you are able, so that we are able, with God's grace, to do what others claim cannot be done, works even greater than these, as Jesus told us. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be upon you this day and walk beside you always. Amen. Go in peace, rejoicing in the power of the Spirit. Alleluia, alleluia. Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia.